Good morning, students. Welcome back in URSS class. Students, we have started our third chapter, that is mineral and power resources. Already we have discussed about minerals a lot of things, and the last topic which we have to cover about minerals, it would be that conservation of the minerals. So we'll start from this. We will start this video from here, that is conservation of the minerals, and the part of the minerals it would be ended by this thing. After then we will discuss about the power resources, right, students? So students, yesterday we have discussed that how useful minerals are for us. We have discussed all those things, that if we want to develop ourselves, and you can say our industrial things, so we need minerals. But my dear student, these minerals, they are unevenly distributed all over the world, whether it is India and whether any part of the country. So that's why we have one need, that minerals must be conserved. So that's why we have to take some steps how to conserve minerals. Like if we think about minerals, there are some non-renewable resources, and these non-renewable resources, they take thousands of years for their formation, and you can say for the concentration of these minerals. So my dear student, here I want to tell you one thing, that we must use some renewable resources instead of the non-renewable resources. Means here that all the non-minerals, if you think about minerals, these are the non-renewable resources, and you can say these are the non-renewable things, and thousands of the years they take for their formation, and you can say the concentration of the minerals in a particular area. So instead of using the non-renewable resources, we must use renewable resources so that we can conserve themselves, right, students? And my dear student, I want to tell you one thing, that because the rate of the formation, it is very slow, but if we think about the consumption of the human being, it is very high. So there is a imbalance. There is an imbalance between the consumption, and you can say between the formation. So that's why we must use minerals in a very, you can say, balanced manner, so that we can conserve our resources. Right, friends? Next thing, that most important, that we must reduce the wastage of the resources. This is the most important thing, that it is very necessary to reduce wastage in the process of the mining also. If we stop the wastage, it means we are saving our minerals, right? And most important thing, we must use recycling of the metals. It is the another way of the conserving the mineral resources. If recycling is there, then we can use that minerals again and again. How we can do with the help of technology, it depend upon the situation, but we must recycle the metals. And by recycling the metals, we can conserve our mineral resources. And dear student, here I want to tell you one thing, that if we over exploit the minerals, it means that it is reduced, but on the other hand, it is also harmful for our environment also. If our environment is polluted, then the survival of the human being, it is very difficult. So over exploitation of the minerals, it is also harmful for the environment also. So we must use them in a very careful manner. Right, friends? We must use alternative method. We must use alternative method, you can say that. Means we use the minerals, those are non-renewable things. But why don't we use the minerals which are renewable? By taking this, by doing this, we can conserve our resources, and we can save our resources. And wastage, it is very most important thing, because we always think that these minerals are the natural things. That's why these are in very huge quantity. So we always waste all these things. So the wastage, it must be reduced. And if we reduce the wastage, then we conserve our resources. You can see minerals also, right? I hope this is clear to all of you. Now, my dear student, we have another topic, that is power resources. We have another topic, that is power resources, and it would be most important, because we have divided this chapter into two parts. The first part is minerals. We have studied it till now. Now the second part, what we are going to discuss here, that is power resources. So dear student, I want to tell you one thing, that what are the power resources here. So let's take a simple definition of the power resources and then continue the things. If we think about resources, the resources which provide us power, they are called power resources. Okay, and these power resources, these are very helpful in the development of the, you can say that, in the development of the people also. So let's think about the power sources. If we think about these power resources, it means these energy resources, they play a very important role in our life. If we think about power and energy, because these power resources provide us power and energy, so this power and energy, it plays an important role in our life. If we think about our life, everything, whatever we want to do, everything, whatever we want to achieve, we have to use some energy and power. Right, students? Right now we are living in the summer season. So we required fan also. For working the fan, we required power, means in the form of electricity. So if we think about power and energy, it plays an important role, and you can say vital role in our life. So we also need power, you can say that, so we must use it in a very careful manner. If we think about power, we need power for industry. Means in industry, there is a power driver machines are there. Power driver machines are there. And these machines, they can be run just only with the help of power. If we think about agriculture, we require power there. Like transport, communication, defense, and you can say all the sphere of life, we required power. Right, students? So let's think about power resources. If we think about power resources, we can divide it into two parts. The first one is conventional and the second one is the non-conventional. The first one is conventional and the second one is the non-conventional. Now, dear student, I want to tell you one thing, that you have studied about renewable resources and non-renewable resources. I think so. You have studied about it. Now, I have told you here that one is conventional and the second one is the non-conventional. I have told you these two points. Now, dear student, from these two, there is one thing that is renewable and the second one is non-renewable. But my dear student, you have be confused related to this thing. Because if we think about the conventional resources, these are the non-renewable resources. And if we think about the non-conventional resources, these are the renewable resources. Remember this thing very clearly, that all the resources, that all the resources, if we think about it, the resources, these are divided into two parts. The first one is the conventional and the second one is non-conventional. And we have studied about resources that these are renewable and non-renewable. Conventional, they belong to non-renewable, and non-conventional, they belong to renewable resources. Be careful while using this thing, right, students? You must be very careful while using this thing also. Clear? So, dear student, also this concept is clear to all of you. So, let's study about these things. Now, first of all, we will discuss about the conventional energy resources, right, student? This would be the first thing. So my dear student, the energy resources which have been in a very common use for a long time, they are commonly known as a conventional resource. Like you can say firewood and fossil fuels. These are the two main important the conventional energy resources. Dear student, if you think about fossil fuels, they belong to the non-renewable resources. That's why I told you that the conventional, here it is non-renewable, and non-conventional, it is here renewable. So firewood and the fossil fuels, these are the two main important conventional energy resource in our Indian society. If we think about fossil fuels, it comprises coals. It comprises coal, which is known as, you can say, buried sunshine also. It means that it is very helpful for our development. That's why it is known as a buried sunshine. Next one is that petroleum. This was also known as a black gold also. This was known also as a black gold. And the next thing is natural gas. and hydroelectricity. Okay, so these are the fossil fuels which we are use as a energy, right? So these are the conventional energy resources. But dear student, if we think about the non-renewable resources and sorry, non-conventional energy resources. So non-conventional energy resources, these are the energy resource which are renewable. Which are renewable? These are the non-conventional energy resources. Solar energy, wind energy, tidal energy. These are the example of the non-conventional resources. And my dear student, I want to tell you one thing, that these non-conventional resources, they are very they are in a very huge amount with us. You can say that these are they are more expensive, because whenever we have to use it, we require more technological upgradation. We can say that, but here I want to tell you one thing, that these are more expensive, but we have to use it. Reason is this, because conventional resources, they are near about to end. वो हमारे पास खत्म होने की कगार पे है. Then what should I do? Then we have to move towards non-conventional energy resources. These are expensive, but my dear student, we have to use it for our survival. And if we can move towards it, my dear student, the initial cost, it may be expensive. The initial cost, it may be expensive, but whenever we use it, it would sort out our all problems. Okay. So dear student, if we think about India, India has a great potential. What about these non-conventional energy resources? Like we have a lot of solar energy, we have wind energy also. So India has a great potential. And if we think about India, as an Indian, we must use it. As an Indian, we must use it. Right now, we are where we are living. We have so much. We have sufficient solar energy. So we can use solar panels for getting the electricity. In this way, we can save our other resources. We can save our other resources, right, students? So this is the non-conventional energy resources, right? Now let's discuss about some conventional energy resources. Like first one is firewood. It is very well known, and you can say बहुत अच्छा माना जाता है जो हमारे Indian society में होता है. So first of all, let's discuss about the firewood. So if we think about firewood, it is widely used for cooking and heating. About in the villages, 50% of the energy, you can say it can be saved by just only firewood, right? So in villages, it is a great source of the energy. And you can say that in villages, it can be used for cooking and heating purpose, right? The second thing, and most important thing, the remains of the plants and the animals, which were buried under the earth surface for a millions of the years, they got converted by the heat and pressure into the fossil fuels. Means the remains of the plants and animals, जो कि हमारे earth surface में दब जाते हैं, and due to the because they are buried under under our earth for the millions of the years, and due to the heat and due to the pressure, it can be converted into fossil fuels. And fossil fuels, we have studied already that coal, petroleum, and natural gas. These were the main fossil fuels as a conventional energy resource which we are using right now, right? But the rate at which the growing world population, it is consuming them in a very greater manner. But the pace of the formation of these resources, it is very slow. So one, I want to tell you one thing, that these resources, if the pace is continues in the same way, these resources can be exhausted very soon. So that's why we have to use another alternatives. We have to use another alternative so that we can save these fossil fuels for our future generation, right? Now, second conventional resource, that is coal. It is also most important fossil fuels, and which can be used, you can say that as a domestic purpose, and you can say in the industrial purpose also, like in the iron steel industry, and you can say in the steam engine, we require electricity, and this coal, it is used to generate electricity in these industry, right? Now, my dear student, we got electricity in the two way. The first one is the thermal power, and the second one is the hydroelectricity. If we think about the thermal power, here we have to use coal to generate electricity. But if we think about hydroelectricity, it is generated by the water, right? So we have thermal power and you can say hydroelectricity power. So for generating electricity, we use coal right now also, right, students? But if we think about coal, if we focus on coal, it was formed millions of the years ago. Millions of the years of the ago, when giant ferns and shrubs, they got buried under the layer of the earth. And after millions of the years, this coal, it was formed. This coal, it was formed, right? But here I have already told you that the conjunction pace, the pace of the conjunction of human being, it is very fast as per the formation of this coal. So we must use it very careful manner. So if we think about coal, this was formed millions of the years ago when giant ferns and shrubs, they got buried under the layer of the earth. So that's why coal is referred as a buried sunshine. This was the basic thing. क्योंकि ये हमारी अर्थ सर्फेस के अंदर से निकलता है, ठीक है, और उसका यूज हम क्या करते हैं, वी यूज इट फॉर एज ए पावर रिसोर्स, एज ए एनर्जी रिसोर्स, दैट्स व्हाई इट इज नोन एज ए ब्राइट सनशाइन. द लीडिंग प्रोड्यूसर ऑफ द कोल इन द वर्ल्ड, दैट इज चाइना, यूएसए, जर्मनी, रशिया, साउथ अफ्रीका एंड फ्रांस. एंड इन इंडिया इट इज रानीगंज, झारिया, धनबाद, बोकारो इन झारखंड. झारखंड इट इज लोकेटेड इन द छोटा नागपुर प्लेटू, which is a storehouse of the minerals, right, students? So I have already told you that the resources, the minerals and the resources, these are unevenly distributed on all over the world. Same thing as in India. If we think about India, it is just only concentrated only on Chota Nagpur Plateau, means the area of Jharkhand and Chhattisgarh. So these are the producing area of the, you can say, coal producing area in India, right? Now let's think about another thing, that is petroleum, which is known as a, you can say that black gold. Petroleum, it is known as a black gold, right, students? Now, my dear student, here I want to tell you that we are using different type of vehicles, and for using those things, we require petrol. We require petrol. I'm saying here petrol. We have two things. One is petrol. The second is petrol. Petrol, it is done by the police force, जो गश्त लगाते हैं, and whatever lubricant, the lubricant which is used in our, you can say that car and vehicles, these are called petrol. So my dear student, petrols, these can be used for our car running, and you can say other for the using of other vehicles also. And oil keeps your cycle from squeaking also. So petrol and oil, they both begin as a thick black liquid that is called petroleum. Means agar main is oil aur petrol ki baat karta hu, use hum petroleum, ye hame petroleum se milta hai. And if we think about this petroleum, this can be found between the layers of the rocks, between the layers of the rock. And we have to make a well, by drilling it, and then we can extract that lubricant from outside. And this petroleum can be this petroleum produce a variety of product like diesel, petrol, kerosene oil, wax, plastics and lubricants also. So we got from this crude oil different type of products, right, students? But this petroleum, ye petroleum jo hai hamare earth surface ke andar kafi gehra hua hai, means kafi gehrai mein daba hua hai, aur hum ise kya karte hain, iske kuye banakar, drilling ke madad se kuye banakar isko extract karte hain. And from this petroleum we got different type of product like diesel, petrol, kerosene, etc. And these can be used you can say that for using our vehicles also, and for we can use it for another purpose also. So that's why this is called this petroleum, it is known as a black gold also, because it is very valuable, and our development, it is also depend on this petroleum. That's why it is called black gold. And if we think about the chief petroleum producing countries in all over the world, this is Iran, Iraq, Saudi Arabia. These are the major areas. Rather than, there are other major areas also like USA, Russia, Venezuela and Algeria. But if we think about this, say Iran, Iraq and Saudi Arabia, these are the major areas. These are the major areas, right, students? Now if we think about India, डिगबोई इन आसाम, बॉम्बे मुंबई हाई जिसे हम कह सकते हैं, या बॉम्बे हाई, इट इज इन मुंबई एंड यू कैन से इट इज इन अरेबियन सी आल्सो, एंड द डेल्टा ऑफ द कृष्णा एंड गोदावरी रिवर. दीज आर द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट थिंग यू कैन से, दीज आर द मोस्ट इंपॉर्टेंट ऑयल फील्ड एंड यू कैन से पेट्रोलियम फील्ड इन आर इंडिया, राइट स्टूडेंट्स. सो दीज आर द थिंग्स एंड दिस इज पेट्रोलियम. Now come to the another, that is natural gas. That is natural gas. If we think about natural gas, it is found with the petroleum deposit. It is found with the petroleum deposit. When crude oil is brought out from the earth's surface, first of all, the product it is released, that is natural gas. जब सबसे पहले हम crude oil को बाहर निकालते हैं ना, सबसे पहले क्या निकलता है? ये natural gas ही निकलती है. Right, students? And if we think about natural gas, it can be used as a domestic purpose and natural industrial fuel also. Major producing areas of the natural gas, that is Russia, Norway, UK and the Netherlands. But on the other hand, if we think about in India, it is Jaisalmer, Krishna and Godavari Delta, Tripura, and there are some areas like in Mumbai High also. So we can get these this natural gas from these areas. Right, students? But my dear student, these are fossil fuels and these are in a very limited quantity. So we have to take care of them. Reason is that sharp increase in our consumption of fossil fuels. Due to it, some resources are near about at the verge of the depletion. Some resources, some of these power resources, they are at the verge of the depletion also. Second thing, the toxic pollutant. The release from this burning fuels. So due to this thing, it can pollute our environment. It can pollute our environment. And unchecked burning of the fossil fuels is like an unchecked dripping tap, which will eventually run dry. Means जितनी स्पीड से हम इसका कंजप्शन करते जा रहे हैं और लगातार इसको बर्निंग करते जा रहे हैं, इससे ये हमारे चीजें तो खत्म तो हो ही जाएंगी, साथ ही साथ हमारे इस एनवायरनमेंट को भी खत्म कर देंगे, बंद कर देंगे. सो दिस हैज टू लेड टू अ टैपिंग फॉर द वेरियस नॉन कन्वेंशनल रिसोर्सेज. इट मींस वी हैव टू मूव टुवर्ड्स द नॉन कन्वेंशनल रिसोर्सेज सो दैट वी कैन यूज देम एज अ अल्टरनेटिव टू फॉसिल फ्यूल्स. सो वी हैव टू मूव टुवर्ड्स द नॉन सॉरी we have to move toward the non-conventional resources, which can be known as a renewable resources. So this non-conventional resources, we will discuss in the next video lecture. Right? I hope the concept is clear to all of you. So I'll see you in the next video. Thank you. Have a nice day.